Hello everyone, this is Naren Krish. In today's video, we are going to see how to install a Kubernetes multinode cluster for local development in less than 10 minutes. I have already explained how to use kind tool to create a local Kubernetes multinode cluster. You can refer the video on the top right corner for that. But the kind tool brings up the nodes or clusters as the Docker image. What if you want something more sophisticated? What if you want to use a virtual machine as your node? The procedure is the same in Windows, Mac OS, or any Linux distribution. I'm going to use Multipass to create VMs and K3S to install a lightweight Kubernetes certified distribution. Start by first downloading the Multipass for your OS. As I'm doing it in Windows, while installing it, it is requesting whether it should be using Hyper-V or VirtualBox for VMs. I'm selecting Hyper-V. You can select VirtualBox if you already have VirtualBox installed in your machine. Once after installation, open your terminal or command prompt. I'm using git bash as I can run Unix commands in Windows. I would highly recommend you to have the same, but not mandatory. Then check if Multipass is installed. Then just run this simple command, multipass launch -n and then the node name. In our case, I'm calling it control plane, which will represent the master in our Kubernetes cluster. The very first launch will take around 5 minutes as it is downloading Ubuntu image, etc. After it is done, repeat the same command for all the worker nodes that you want to create. I am creating two worker nodes, worker 1 and worker 2. The next step is to install K3S, which is a lightweight Kubernetes distribution from Rancher, and a simple command like this. Please note, I have provided all these commands in the description for your easy access. Once after K3S is installed, we need to extract the token and the IP of this control plane. Let's retrieve the token of this K3S node using this command. Followed by this command, multipass info control plane, and make note of the IPv4 address. Please note, as I'm using git bash, I'm able to store the variables like that and retrieve them using dollar symbol. If you're using Windows command prompt, you'll have to store them using set command and retrieve them using %%. Check the description for more information on that. Now let's install K3S into the worker 1. Note the variable IP and token which we extracted from previous commands. You can also replace the actual values if you have not stored them in variables. It takes less than 50 seconds for the workers to join. Repeat the same with worker 2. Again, I have listed all the commands in the description, so feel free to use it. That's it. Our cluster is ready. The next final step is to get our kubeconfig file to access this cluster from your local machine. All you have to do is run this command to store the file locally. Inside the file, replace 127.0.0.1, which is a default IP, with the IP of your control plane, which we extracted before. Then use kubeconfig variable to point this file. Finally, now we can access our shiny cluster using kubectl commands. Of course, if you don't have kubectl already installed, install one. If you have Docker for Windows or Mac, it ships with it. That's it for our Wacky Wednesday. Thanks for watching and keep learning.